गुड मॉर्निंग टू वन एंड ऑल। आई फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल थैंक्स इंस्पेक्टर डॉक्टर कुलकर्णी सर, डॉक्टर थेपड़े सर एंड डॉक्टर हरपाली मैम फॉर गिविंग मी एन अपॉर्चुनिटी टू शेयर सम ऑफ द नॉलेज विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ योर पर्सनल पोर्टफोलियो वेबसाइट यूजिंग सम फ्री टूल्स अवेलेबल ऑनलाइन। सो आई विल फर्स्ट लिस्ट आउट हाउ मेनी सच टूल्स आर अवेलेबल and then we'll have a demonstration on one of such tool. Mostly all these online portals are similar with respect to their structure of development and design, like drag and drop type of structure is there. So these are few portals available like Weebly, then Google Sites, Wix, then GitHub and WordPress is something if you are with some IT and computer background and if you know PHP, HTML, that type of part, then you can work on it. But without any knowledge of any programming language, you can work on Weebly or Google Sites or Wix. So we'll start with the demonstration of Weebly, because let me share the screen first. Okay. So my screen is visible to all.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay, thank you. So when we log in into Weebly, there are two, three ways possible. You can log in with your Google account, already Gmail ID if you have, then you can log in with Google. Otherwise, you need to create an account and then you can have the login into the Weebly portal. After login, the best part is you may get some kind of already one site I have, so I have to go to the ad site. Otherwise, this options you will get when you sign in for the first time. So there are two particular choices first being asked. You want website or you want any e-commerce website. So we require a normal website. And now various themes or various templates are available as per the business, as per the requirement. So as we are working on personal websites, or it can be a portfolio website or personal website. So you can select any theme. You can do n number of modifications in the on that respective theme. I will just go through what themes are available. Any number of new web pages can be added. So that type of templates are provided. Weebly, the reason for selecting Weebly is it is having very good graphical GUI than Google Sites, because Weebly is mostly working on graphical look and feel of your and the engage to have the website client specific means students or for us the students and others can be interact very well. So let me select any particular theme. You will get first preview of the theme. If you are satisfied with that, like this is home page, you can do some modification in the already existing theme. Then these are some of the tabs, you can add delete the tab and then start editing. Now, when you start editing the theme, you will get on the left side many elements available for you to drag and drop. Now, elements are what? Elements can be image element, it can be text, it can be if you want to embed YouTube video or something. So that can be the element. Before that, you have to mention some domain name. Domain here, it is public, so it is free if you are hosting it on a Weebly. Free login and free domain. So whatever domain you will put, for example, I am putting here Ethan D, then that will be considered as after that the weebly.com will be added. Okay. So already I think it is. So like that the options will be available. Then if I want, I can choose it and then start editing. Now this I was talking about the elements, key many elements will be available. In template you can do changes as well. Okay, now I will just go through some of the elements which are frequently used, like spacer. Spacer is something to add new lines or some space in between the element. It can be resized. Okay, whatever space you want accordingly you can resize it. You can change the background image. Okay, you can have an number of images which are already present on Weebly portal, as well as you can have your own image as well. So if you click on edit, here we have the option of selecting all the backgrounds which are already available on Weebly for free, or you can upload any specific image you want. So both the options are available. After selecting it, you can work on this some filters. You can blur that to some extent. You can darken that image so that if you want ki the background should be dark and the whatever text you will add, it should be light, then in that case this type of design can be used. If you want to zoom in, zoom out the background image, so like that also you can work on the background. Okay, and then finally you here we have the option of save. Okay, so like that we can do some modifications. Then second element is something title and text, which we require maximum. Okay, so it's simple, like if I want to add some title here, after this just drag it and drop it here, so it will show you some. You can have your, for example, I want to like that, you can add the title. In that again we have some choice of resizing the font size, coloring the font. Then you can provide the hyperlink. If you want to provide, for example, if you want to provide some hyperlink to other website, then just click on this and add the website URL. Here you can have that. For example, I am adding. So like that, it is being linked. Open in new window is means if you click on, if any user is clicking on that, he will redirect to the new tab and the hyperlink that website will open in a new window. So like that the options are there. So it will look like this. Okay, so this is how the text title can be used. If you want to add the text, you can just drag and drop the text and we'll start editing the text like that. Then one more thing we require most, that is image. Now image, here we are having three variants or three designs. If you want to include a single image, like this is an example of a single image, so just drag, you can add that single image. We have a resizing option for that image as well. You can click on it. For example, let me just add any image into this. So it depends on the size, whatever image size you are having, depending on that it will take the time to upload and have the further things available for you. Images, like I'm explaining, there are two, three variants are available. You can show in a gallery style as well, or you can have this slideshow view also. Okay, so if you have multiple images to show, then accordingly you can select the gallery or slideshow element, so that those multiple images can be added. They can be sequentially arranged and you can display it one by one. Okay, let me take different image. Okay, now after adding the image, we have that options of resizing it. Then you can have some other options on image. If you want to have the light box effect, light box means when you click on the image, that image will appear as a separately in a full screen size. You can link anything to your image. If you want key, if clicked on that image, users should redirect to some website, that linking is also possible. Alignment is also there, center, left, right alignment can be there. Spacing is also possible with respect to this. Now this is our element, image element. So spacing between the elements, upper element and lower element, side, left side and right side, what margin you want. So that margin also we can select. Then we can have caption to this image. For example, if I want to add key, this is so below this image you will get this caption displayed. And then in advanced you can have a border. So just select which type of border, which color, gray or black. And if you want some alternate text to be given, sometimes image cannot be loaded, so that time this can be useful. If I make it central, so like this your image can be displayed. For multiple images, here you will get upload, you get chance to upload the multiple images, and you can have the gallery. Slideshow is also for the same, only for slideshow these number of styles are available. For example, this, if you click on this right left side, then next image will appear. This is carousel effect. It is horizontal carousel effect in which at the bottom some thumbnails will be there. This is also one effect where on the top some thumbnails effect will be there. This is on vertical carousel effect. So like that some styles are available. Accordingly, you can add the styles slideshow in if there are multiple images are present on the needs to be added on the web page. So this is one element which is maximum use. Then we have some option of embedding the Google map. Other than that, I think button is something which is maximum used. So just drag and drop button. We can have some styles for button. So in these styles, by default styles are there some. So you can add the buttons on your web page. Then position, linking. Linking is almost given to everyone because linking is base or the base of your search engine optimization. So almost for every element there is hyperlink provision is there. Okay. Then some options like very important is your divider. Yes. So divider is something. If this particular image I don't want key, it should cover entire horizontal space. I want some bifurcation in that. So I will what I can do and just select the divider and put it here so that it will help me in dividing it in a section wise. Now this is one section, this is other section. So now the web page is being divided into two sub sections. One more, if I want division on the same, I can just drag and drop the division. So here is one, two, and this is third. So like that you can divide it into multiple frames on a single web page using the divider. Divider and spacer almost work, they are somewhat same, but spacer mostly help you in adding some space in between the two elements. So like this is this spacer, it will help you to add specific width space in between your elements. Then for us, one more important element is YouTube video embedding. So if you have any YouTube video which you need to show as a part of your web page, then this option, embedding option, is provided. Let me take any YouTube video. So after selecting this, what we need to provide the URL of that video only, so that preview will be occurred there. For example, any video, just I will select, we'll just take its URL and put it here. And some, so this view is available now. You can have that position, spacing, some options like, you can have the size as well. If you want it in a small size, medium size, large size, HD, auto, like that. So if our videos are there, then we can put it in single row. If you want 2-3 videos to be there, then again divider will be helpful So just put a divider so that second video can be added in this section. So this is also one of the element which can be useful for us. These elements are available in a paid version like HD videos and audio directly embedding on our own website. So it requires hosting space with us. And because this YouTube embedding doesn't require any hosting space, that's why it is available in a free version. Then Flash element is also available for PDF and other documents. This is for e-commerce. If we want to add some social icons, our social icons, then that option is also available. So again, many which icons needs to be shown, you have that choice. You can link, provide your respective social icon link, so they will be active. Means when anyone is clicking on that, he will be able to redirect to your particular account, along with some spacing in between the elements. One more element which I feel it is useful. If we have any script PPTs, because script is giving us an opportunity to upload our documents, so you can have that script embedding available in Weebly. So just you need to upload that file, select the version size, whether you want in small, medium, large size, and that PDF can be uploaded. So for our maybe for our papers and all, this can be useful. So when you upload the particular file, it will be available as a preview and user will get an opportunity to download it and view it or share it like that. Now this is about a single web page. If I want some new web pages to be added, then here we have that option to add the page. Now web page is having some categories. The standard web page means in that can be clickable, that will be part of the header. And it will be common when if I click on any web page of my website. Blog page is something where you want to add your own blogs. So blog structure is different. Okay. Then category, product, and all these pages are applicable to the e-commerce website. External pages, reference to the external page. Non-clickable menu is a landing page, generally used in lead generation by some of the sales team of any particular business. So generally will require either standard or blog page. Standard page means it is same like this, like my work, about, contact, these are available, no? Like that only. I will just show you blog page, which can be also useful to us. So if I add the blog page, so here that structure will appear. We can add the, just let me go to the build section. Okay. Hello. Hello.
Yes, sir. You are audible.
Audible, sir. Okay. You are. This button is not working. From this option, we can add the new blog. New post is nothing but the blog. Before adding the blog, in a blog, we may have some images, text content. So if it is available in that sequential, in that sequence with us already, then we can add it as early as possible. Then blog settings are there. Means how many blogs to be visible on your blog page. You can control that. Then whether that social share button needs to be shown, sidebar needs to be shown. So like this, some of the options are there. Then for comments also, you can control if on your blog who can comment, there can be some moderation. You can get a notification when someone is commenting on your blog. Then you can put captcha for anyone before posting any comment on your blog. So like that, the settings can be done with respect to the blog. So let me just check whether that option is. Let us save it. Yes. So in blog, we have this arrangement like blog title, then element. Now drag elements means what how your blog content to be organized. So it can be again title, text, image, some galleries or slides or anything. So your blog content will appear here. After making it live, for example, I will just put it first, demo blog, and some element. So like if I type here, this is first blog, and then we need to click on this post so that our blog is being added to that respective post. So it will look like this as a preview. So title, some content, whatever you will have, some social icons as we have selected. You can add LinkedIn and others as well if you receive any comment, then like that. Here also you can add some information about the author, who is writing the blogs, and some summary about that respective blog categories and all. So these elements are, I think, useful for us for making our own portfolio website. Other than that, if you have means for with respect to the Weebly, I thought ki these are the elements which we require on a frequent basis. Apart from that, again, some more extra and what you can say, some upgraded features like embedding a code or read more break. Like we can use it read more in this blog, because if your blog is too long, then after one paragraph you can just drag and drop this and add that particular section. For example, we'll just show you. If too much long is your content, then I can add this read more button. So after that particular one paragraph, user will get an option of read more, and if he click on it, then only he will able to see the further content. So like that, you can organize your blog in some short summarized view if multiple blogs are available on your page. Okay. And embed code is something, there are many things we can embed on our website. Our own website. So for that, HTML code and some iframe code is required. So this is also possible. So these are two something additional or extra features are given in a free version. Rest mostly we have covered.